Hello folks, Robert from Marine Depot here. As a reef nerd, it can sometimes be difficult to make new friends. When all you want to do is talk about fish and corals and aquarium equipment, keeping people's interest can be a real challenge. Joining a local reef club is one of the best ways to connect with people in your area that share your enthusiasm for reef keeping. Plus, as you'll soon discover, participating in a reef club can open up many new opportunities and ideas that will help you learn and progress in the aquarium hobby. In this marinedepot.com video, we sit down with two board members from the Southern California Marine Aquarium Society to discuss the benefits of joining a local reef club. During our conversation, we cover a lot of ground, including the history of SCMAS, tank tours, workshops, and share some great laughs that only other reefers can relate to. We also talked about the humble beginnings of Reef-A-Palooza and how this annual celebration of reef keeping has evolved into one of the world's largest aquarium trade shows. If you're unfamiliar with aquarium clubs or considering joining a local chapter, keep watching to learn about all the great ways that joining a local reef club can benefit you and your tank.
And I'm Greg Carroll from the Southern California Marine Aquarium Society.
Mark Trimble from Southern California Marine Aquarium Society.
So what is SCMAS, or the Southern California Marine Aquarium Society?
Southern California Marine Aquarium Society is a reef club that started in 1984, one of the first dedicated marine aquarium clubs in the country.
So being active members and obviously board members, what do you guys find to be the most, you know, satisfying or rewarding part of being a part of an aquarium club?
I look at it as just sharing my knowledge and also the opportunity to learn from the others.
Okay, so not only the social aspect, but also the educational aspect.
Correct.
Like you learn from other people.
It's also nice because you've got face-to-face at a meeting.
Sure.
You're not sitting behind, with the internet, and I'm not knocking the internet, there's a ton of information on there, but a lot of times you don't know where that information is coming from. With a club, you know who you're talking to. You know where they've been, you know how long they've been in this situation. So you there's a trust that builds up in that situation, and you have an idea, and that's important to me.
Do you find it that it's beneficial for everybody, or just the more advanced, like dedicated reef hobbyists?
How we define an advanced aquarist is someone who knows there's a lot more to know.
Correct.
We develop patience too.
Yeah.
It's not something easy, but patience.
Yeah, I always tell the guys that, you know, I learn every day, you know. I mean, when it comes to aquariums, it's pretty much endless.
It's absolutely beneficial for everyone. One of the things that I'm most impressed about is when we have new members show up, one of the things we always ask them, you know, what size tank do you have, and so forth. And more, I find myself talking to some, you know, introducing someone that's new to the club that doesn't have a tank yet. They're trying to learn all they can learn before even starting.
And because we've got such a wide group of knowledgeable membership, from the expert to the beginner, we also want to make sure that when someone comes in that is new, they feel very welcome there.
So you talk about your monthly meetings. What kind of activities go on at the meeting? You know?
Typically in our meetings, we start off with introducing, you know, new members. We may make some announcements. We'll sometimes have a guest speaker. You know, sometimes it's just a roundtable discussion. Those, in my opinion, a lot of times those are the best meetings that we have. So those roundtable discussions where we get people who may be having a problem be able to talk about their problem, and to see the room come alive with ideas on how to fix it is just amazing.
So you talk about speakers at the club meetings. And what kind of speakers have you guys had at the club? And I guess maybe who's your favorites or some of your favorites?
I mean, we've had, you know, Jake Adams of Reef Builders, Sanjay Joshi of Penn State University.
We've had Julian Sprung.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
We've had Michael Paletta way back when. We've had, what we try to do, we try to keep an ear open for whoever people are reading or listening to or finding, you know, articles written by. So we try to find a popular, you know, person maybe discussing something, some subject that's popular, and then go after that person to try to get them to come out to the meetings.
Exactly.
So we try to hit a wide variety of speakers.
It doesn't hurt to have marine depot in your backyard. One time we had the opportunity, we had a frag, just a local frag swap set up for our meeting, and I got a call that David Saxby was in town, and he's got an incredible reef tank, and this is when everybody was checking out his reef tank on YouTube.
I mean, one of the most exciting things, you get opportunities to see and meet people that you may never have an opportunity to see or meet. So as far as, you know, in addition to these, the monthly club meetings, what other kind of events do you guys, let's say, fund or promote?
We've done, in the past, we've done these little one-day workshops.
Another thing we do is tank tours. It's an opportunity for, you know, the members to go from, you know, one member's house, check out their tanks, see how they're doing things. I mean, it never ceases to amaze me how many good ideas come out of those tank tours.
Another thing about the tank tours, which I find so fun, is you see another gentleman's tank, another member's tank, and maybe he has a fish in there that you would never think to put in the tank because you heard that it nips corals or it's not a friendly fish or whatever. But it might have been a fish that you like, you know, and you always kind of wished. And then you see someone who's actually got one, oh, does that work? Hey, I might try it now. Or vice versa, you might say, hey, yeah, this guy's a real beast. I got to get him out and I figured out how. You know, so.
You know, I know that SCMAS has a huge role in Reef-A-Palooza, so why don't you tell us all about Reef-A-Palooza, what it is, and the role that SCMAS plays in Reef-A-Palooza.
Well, Reef-A-Palooza is, you know, it started off in Mark's backyard. We decided we wanted to do something more than a frag swap.
We gave them a little bit more. We went out of our way and then realized that people really enjoyed it.
And then the next year we decided let's do it again. And we had 400 people.
Wow.
And Mark basically said, you know what, this is not happening in my backyard anymore.
Yeah, no more house parties.
So
so then we had a porta potty in the front.
Exactly.
Oh, man.
So Ben over at Marine Depot offered to host the third one in their
parking lot.
Yeah.
After that, we moved to the fairgrounds. We started in one building. Moved to a bigger building. We're now in a 40,000 square foot building. And, you know, bringing in, you know, an average over the last couple of years, 5,000 people in the weekend, 2-day weekend. So it's become an amazing show.
For anybody who hasn't attended a Reef-A-Palooza before, what could they expect to see at the show?
Anything, corals and fish under the sun, just about.
Yeah.
You know, we try to make it, something that we as a hobbyist, myself, Greg, what we enjoy. So we go through almost every piece of equipment that is needed to create your dream. You know, so people can look at the dream already put together and then they can look at the parts that create the whole.
The best of the best coral vendors, the best of the best manufacturers there. You know, one of the things that most people will notice that's completely different about our show is when they walk up and the band is out there playing.
Yeah.
You know, they understand, hey, this is meant to be fun.
We want people to come in, and whether they spend the entire day or just a couple of hours, you know, they feel it was well worthwhile.
Mm-hmm. Everything a person would want, you know, we have it in the raffle.
It's cool.
You know, so they can literally walk away with, you know, buying a few raffle tickets and walk away with hundreds, thousands of dollars worth of equipment. We now have a show in Orlando. Last year was our first show in the New York area. Everywhere Reef-A-Palooza goes, everyone knows the name Reef-A-Palooza and they come out.
I think that's what makes Reef-A-Palooza so special.
Right.
Because it's fun for everybody, you know? Whether you're advanced, beginning, it's a great place to go and have fun.
Mm-hmm.
I hope that our fun Q&A with Mark and Greg has inspired you to join an aquarium club, and you can visit the Education Center on our website to find your local chapter today. Countless thanks to all of the members at SCMAS for sharing their time and knowledge with us and for organizing one of our favorite events, Reef-A-Palooza. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.